Okay. Good morning. Welcome to today's St. Louis County Board meeting, November 24th, 2020. As per usual, we take a moment of silence for victims of violence, foreign and domestic, and then we'll go to the Pledge of Allegiance. But I would really, really like to say thank you to all the frontline workers out there. You are the reason we are able to continue to function because of the hard work you put in. It's amazing what you're doing for this country with all the hard work you're putting in. So thank you to all our frontline workers. God bless each and every one of you. We'll take a moment of silence and go into the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Such nice chairs. Okay, we'll move right in. Since we have a new guy here, I would ask Mr. Chapman if he would do a roll call.
Commissioner Jewell.
Here.
Commissioner Boyle.
Here.
Commissioner Olson.
Here.
Commissioner McDonald.
Here.
Commissioner Musa.
Here.
Commissioner Nelson.
Here.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Here. Thank you. At this time, citizens will be allowed to address the board on items not on the agenda. Speakers will be limited to 5 minutes each. Do we have anyone virtually or here or?
Hold on.
Okay.
No,
okay, we'll move on. Items listed on the board agenda or committee of the whole agenda, citizens will be allowed to address the board at the time of the motions on the floor. Move on to consent agenda.
So moved, Mr. Chair.
Moved by Commissioner Nelson.
Second, Jewell.
Second by Commissioner Jewell. Bill, could you do a roll call, please?
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle.
Aye.
Commissioner Olson.
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald.
Aye.
Commissioner Musa.
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson.
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye. Thank you. Under the regular agenda, we have the finance and budget. It's an application for on sale Sunday and on sale intoxicating liquor license by Highway 5. It's changed hands. It's unorganized township 5129. And it has
move
not been
to suspend
committed.
The rules, Mr. Chair.
Okay, move to suspend the rules. Second by Commissioner McDonald. Discussion? Phil, could you?
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle.
Aye.
Commissioner Olson.
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald.
Aye.
Commissioner Musa.
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson.
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye.
Okay. I move the resolution.
Okay, moved by Commissioner McDonald. Is there a second?
Support.
Second by Musel. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Mr. Chair, just a very quick explanation. We approved these individuals through our liquor committee process. They hadn't completed their sub-S corporation paperwork yet. That is the only change that is taking place here. Is that it is the license will be in the sub-S. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you.
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle.
Aye.
Commissioner Olson.
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald.
Aye.
Commissioner Musa.
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson.
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye. Thank you. Next, under Public Safety and Corrections Committee, it's acceptance of the innovative prosecution solutions in combining violent crime grant. It has not been so into committee, so it requires.
I'd move to suspend the rules.
Okay, moved by Commissioner McDonald.
Support.
Second by Commissioner Nelson.
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle.
Aye.
Commissioner Olson.
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald.
Aye.
Commissioner Musa.
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson.
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye. Deputy, would you like to frame?
I move the resolution.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay. Support Olson.
Okay, moved by McDonald, second by Olson.
Mr. Chair, Commissioners, the St. Louis County Attorney's Office had previously applied for a grant of funding to assist with the efforts to modernize its technology in the Attorney's Office to help them with greater tracking of data, case management, and hopefully some caseload reduction. We did recently receive notification from the feds that the county was awarded the grant in the amount of $340,000 to assist with these efforts. Specifically, the county intends to implement the grant by investing in a new case management software system in the attorney's office. There are no matching requirements, so the $340,000 is a straight grant. However, there are some additional costs that the attorney's office will need to respond and address just related to the ongoing maintenance and other issues associated with the software itself. So I think that's pretty short and sweet to what it is. Attorney Rubin may have additional information related to that, but the board is asked to accept the grant from the U.S. Department of Justice Bureau in the amount of $340,000.
Comments? Questions?
Mr. Chair, just a little background on this too. Our current case management system was implemented in 1992. That's before the internet. And we've been patching it. One thing this pandemic has revealed is the weaknesses in the system. Because many of our attorneys, we're doing everything online now and virtual court appearances, they need that data immediately. And it's not retrievable the way it should be. Our new system will help with these kinds of hearings. It will give us accurate information, and especially for juveniles on the range. We used to have a person doing juvenile prosecution in Virginia and in Hibbing. We've combined it now. Now we have one of our attorneys in Virginia. Leah Stauber is the one doing that. She's doing the juvenile on both sides of the range. And what that does is that gives us consistency. But she needs that data, too, exactly what's going on. Law enforcement, we'll get better information from law enforcement to follow the trends and where we have to put our efforts. So this is, and the person I give credit for this is Wade Baxter. He happened to see this pop up, this opportunity, and he talked to me about it. And I said, it looks fantastic, but we don't write many grants. You know, we don't have a grant writer in the office. But he worked with it with Tyler Konevchuk, one of our attorneys on the range, and Jess Fraley. The three of them put this together, and we were fortunately one of the agencies that did receive it. That's a lot of money, but we're really excited about it. Thank you.
Anyone else? Okay.
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle. I think Commissioner Boyle might be on mute. Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye. Thank you. For the third item, we have under Central Management and Intergovernmental Committee, rescind County Board Resolution number 20-137. And declare a continued state of local emergency in St. Louis County. It has not been to committee.
Move to suspend the rules, Mr. Chair.
Okay, moved by Nelson. Is there a second?
Support.
Second by Musso. Bill, could you do it?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
No. Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye. Okay.
Move the resolution, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Moved by Nelson. Second by
Olson.
Second by Olson.
Okay. Mr. Chair, Commissioners, earlier this year, the county issued an order declaring an emergency as a result of the COVID pandemic. That order followed similar orders, which were issued by both our state and federal governments. Under the SLC order, There were a number of action steps that were included in our resolution. One of those actions provided the county administrator with certain emergency authorities, which were granted under Minnesota statute. With the rapidly changing environment associated with the pandemic, it has been suggested that the county broaden these authorities to ensure that we are in a position to act quickly and respond accordingly with anything that that might be changing on the state and federal side. With that in mind, the board has been provided a resolution which, in addition to the county administrator, adds the deputy county administrator and director of human resources administration to be added to the list allowed to act in the case there's a situation where we need to do and take some action under that emergency order, and that's statute 1237. In considering this action, the board should also rescind the original resolution associated with the emergency order. The board is being asked to consider the resolution as presented.
Okay, we'll open it up.
Mr. Chair, I just think this is just the evolution of the process here and making sure that we're in a position to be nimble enough and be able to react in a timely fashion to what is an ever-changing situation. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
I agree. Okay, Phil, would you do a roll call, please?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye. Okay, thank you. Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
McDonald by Musa.
Support.
Okay. Phil, could you do a roll call?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye. Thank you. Stand adjourned. Or would you like anyone need a break? Let's take a 5-minute break and we'll come back.
Here we go.
All right. Welcome back to November 24th, 2020 meeting. We are going to open up the committee of the whole. Would you be so kind as to take a roll call?
Commissioner Jewell.
Squidward.
Here.
Commissioner Boyle. Commissioner Boyle. Commissioner Olson.
Here.
Commissioner McDonald?
Here.
Commissioner Musa?
Here.
Commissioner Nelson?
Here.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Here. Thank you. We've got the consent agenda. Is there anything?
I move the consent.
Okay, moved by Commissioner McDonald, second by?
Second.
By Jewell. Discussion. Phil, could you do a roll call?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle. Commissioner Olson.
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald.
Aye.
Commissioner Musa.
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson.
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye. Thank you. Move on to establishment of public hearings, finance and budget. Mr. Nelson.
Thank you, Chair Commissioner Yugovich. We do have three public hearings to schedule. The first is to establish a public hearing to consider off-sale intoxicating liquor license in an unorganized township 59-21 for Tuesday, December 15th, 2020 at 9:50 a.m. or thereabouts. And I would move it. Is there support?
I'll second.
Supported by Commissioner Yugovich. And clerk, discussion on public hearings, I don't believe there will be any, but if there is, sorry, I'll ask. Seeing none. Clerk Chapman, would you please take the roll?
Commissioner Jewell.
Can I ask a quick question of our attorney? If can I run all three of these and have one vote at the end of it?
Nobody objects? Absolutely.
Is there any objection to doing all three of these and having one vote from commissioners?
Sounds fine.
Hearing done. I will move on and we'll do this as one vote establishing all three public hearings. The second public hearing is for suspension revocation of liquor licenses for property tax non-payment. Again, this is for December 15th, 2020 at 9:55 or thereabouts. And I would move that. Is there support? Supported by Commissioner McDonald. And again, any discussion on this? Hearing none, I will move on to the third, is to establish a public hearing for a proposed land exchange between St. Louis County and Biosolids Disposal Site Authority. And again, this is on Tuesday, December 15th, 2020 at 10 a.m. or thereabouts. And I would move that as well. Is there support? Supported by Commissioner Yugovich. Clerk Chapman, this vote is for all three of the public hearings. And I want to make sure that all commissioners understand that. This sets all three public hearings. Would you please take the roll, Clerk Chapman?
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle.
Aye.
Commissioner Olson.
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald.
Aye.
Commissioner Musa.
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson.
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye. Okay, we'll move on. The regular agenda, first under Public Works and Transportation, Chair McDonald.
Thank you, Chair Yugovich. Before us today, we have one item. It is an awarding of bids for bridge construction projects on County Highway 4 in Gunnison Township. Mr. Musoff, would you care to move
Absolutely
this?
Would move it.
I would support it. And with that, you know, it's interesting to see. I believe this, correct me if I'm wrong, I believe this is our first project on the new bonding money. So we're already working on that. Two projects that need to be done, very competitive on the bids. We had 9 bidders, and the bids came in very good, very competitive, and you know, putting in some box culverts on Highway 4. So I'll turn it over to administration for further framing.
Quickly, Mr. Chair, Commissioners, Public Works has been preparing for the improvement project on the two bridges, as referred to on County Road 4 in Gunnison Township, and it is the replacement of 2 box culverts in these areas. As noted, 9 bids, excellent bids. Primarily, we hope, due to the fact that we were bidding this earlier than later, this go-around here. And it is the first projects using the new sales tax bonds funding that we have. So, exciting opportunity to take advantage of those monies that we have. Low bid was from TNT Construction out of Grand Rapids at a bid of $1,164,000. And would ask the board to authorize and award the bridge project to TNT Construction in that amount.
Any comments from commissioners? Commissioner Nelson.
Mr. Chair, very briefly, thank you for your hard work on this and thank all Public Works. This is when we as a board and this board for putting together that bonding package, when we as a board give the resources necessary to Public Works response, and this is a great example, and people getting out of the chute next spring, it's going to be so important for people to get back to work, and these projects are going to be a big part of our construction trades people getting out there and getting back to work early next spring. So again, thank you, Chair Commissioner McDonald, and all of Public Works for their work on this.
Thank you, Commissioner. Anyone else? Hearing none, Clerk Chapman, would you take the roll, please?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle? Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye.
Back to you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Under Finance and Budget, we have Chair Nelson.
Thank you, Chair Commissioner Yugovich. Your agenda indicates that we do have three items under Finance and Budget. I will say to this board that administration has asked that we pull item number one for some additional legal review and possibly a different scenario on this. So if there's no objections to that being pulled, it's not time sensitive. Deputy Administrator Fritzinger, that's correct?
That's correct.
Not time sensitive, so we're going to delay that action at this point. The second is the sale of non-conforming county fee land to the adjacent property owner in Alango Township. And I would look to Commissioner McDonald if he'd care to move that.
I would move that.
Moved by Commissioner McDonald. I'll support that. Deputy Administrator Fritzinger. And I got to find out. EAF. Can we use an acronym for that instead of Deputy Administrator Fritzinger? That's a mouthful, guys. So I'm just going to go DAF.
I've been called worse.
Have you? Okay.
I could be much more colorful.
DAF.
Yeah.
DAF.
Got it. Thank you, Mr. Chair, Commissioners. You do have a replacement resolution here that was handed out related to this item. The only change in this is related to the legal description. So just so you're aware of that. But we did receive a request to purchase county-owned fee land from Richard Erickson. The land in question is non-conforming fee land located in Alango Township and is approximately 1 acre in size. The Erickson family owns the land adjoining this piece of property. Under Minnesota statute, the value is to be set at no less than 90% of the fair market value, or in this case, $1,980. The family and Mr. Erickson are comfortable in that amount. County staff has reviewed the request and has not identified any objections to the application for this piece of property. As a result, board is asked to approve the sale of the unimproved non-conforming fee land to Richard and Jeffrey Erickson in the amount of $1,980 and the associated tax and recorded fees.
Thank you, DAF. Questions? Concerns? I will say that this is addressing some concerns that we've had on a number of these very small sites where they've become dump sites, basically repositories for people dropping off stuff that they don't want anymore. And by getting these back in the hands of the private landowners, that situation will go away. And we do have a number of these things we've worked through, probably half of them up to this point, but we still have a bunch more. Commissioner McDonald.
Is this the old Alango school?
I believe it is, yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. That's.
And a lot of them up there, Commissioner McDonald, are old gravel pits where we retained only the active portion of the gravel pit and the balance of the land was sold. And so consequently, these small parcels became places for people to get rid of unwanted items at, and like I said, we've gone through a number of these, and I'm glad to see this one being done as well. Questions on the from commissioners on screen. Seeing none, Clerk Chapman, would you please take the roll?
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle.
Aye.
Commissioner Olson.
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald.
Aye.
Commissioner Musa.
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson.
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye.
Thank you, Commissioners. We have one more item under the Finance and Budget Committee. It is a resolution recommending the approval of up to $68,000 in a one-time grant for financial assistance to assist the town of Morris to purchase 4 parcels of land. Commissioner McDonald, I know you've worked very hard on this. Would you care to move it?
I would move this.
Moved by Commissioner McDonald. Is there support? Supported by Commissioner Yugovich. Deputy Administrator Fritzinger.
Mr. Chair, Commissioners, the county has been asked to provide grant funding in the amount of $68,000 to Morris Township for this project. The funds themselves will be used to assist in the acquisition of 4 parcels of land associated with the Taconite State Trail. Morris has been working with the DNR to acquire these parcels to ensure that the trail continues to run in this area of the state.
As noted, Commissioner McDonald has been part of a lot of those discussions with the folks in this area. Morse did reach an agreement to purchase the property for $136,000 and then agreed to provide easements to the DNR across this property for the trail itself. And the parcels, the result of this, would remain open for public use and future recreation development is the plan from the township. The IRRR has also been asked to partner in this project, being asked to fund the remaining $68,000. While Morse itself has funded the down payment, they would not have additional dollars or monies put into the project. Should the board support the request, it is recommended to use our economic development fund as the source consistent with the economic development benefits of this project in the area. And with that, the board is asked to approve a one-time grant to Morse Township in the amount of $68,000 to acquire public lands with certain conditions as are identified in the resolution attached.
Thank you, Deputy Administrator Britzinger. Commissioner McDonald.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chair. Again, this has been, as DAF has stated, this has been a long process, working with the McKayhill Trust and working closely with the Town of Morse supervisors and staff there. I'd like to thank them for hanging in there on this. And just so everybody knows, we had contacted the DNR, and as of right now, there is some freeze on monies with the DNR. If the monies are appropriated from the DNR, they would go back to us at St. Louis County to get the $68,000 and put that back into our coffers. So it's something that we need to keep this Taconite Trail open. When we're talking economic development, if that trail would close this winter to snowmobiles, that would be not something we would like to see happen. So I speak in big favor of this grant, and with work that's going on through the IRRR and the DNR, hopefully they will step up to the plate and put their money in there as well. So thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Commissioner McDonald. Any further comments on this? Seeing none, Clerk Chapman, would you please take the roll?
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle.
Aye.
Commissioner Olson.
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald.
Aye.
Commissioner Musa.
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson.
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich, that is all I have under the Finance and Budget Committee. Back to you.
Thank you. Under Environment and Natural Resource Committee, we have Chair Musso.
Thank you, Chair. One item today under Environment and Natural Resources, and that would be letter number 20-428. It's an agreement with GMEN Environmental Services for recyclable material haulage. Looks like some of the facilities in Virginia and our northern areas. Anybody care to move that one?
I would.
Moved by Nelson.
Yes. Support.
Support by McDonald. Deputy Administrator.
Mr. Chair, Commissioners, the county currently contracts for certain recycling services for GMN Environmental Services. Our contract for that service right now expires at the end of the year on December 31st. GMN has provided quality and cost-effective service for our residents during the tenure of this existing contract that we have. Staff has followed Minnesota statute, negotiated a new five-year agreement with the company at a total cost of approximately $975,000. Staff believes that we would like to continue that arrangement because of the quality that we have received during this time frame. Board is asked to approve a five-year agreement with GMEN Environmental Services for recycling and facility operations at the St. Louis County Recycling Facility in Virginia.
Thank you, Deputy Administrator. It seems that GMEN has been a good partner for the county as we've been moving with them. Questions, comments, Commissioners? Clerk Chapman, I take roll, please.
Commissioner Jewell.
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle.
Aye.
Commissioner Olson. Commissioner McDonald.
Aye.
Commissioner Musa.
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson.
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich.
Aye.
All right, thank you. That's all I have. Chair, back to you.
Thank you. And next we have Central Management and Intergovernmental Committee. Chair Jewell.
Chair Jukovic, thank you. We have one item. It is the appointments to fill vacancies in the CDBG Citizens Advisory Committee. There were three openings. We had three individuals apply. One from Hermantown, Jim Rich, one from Rice Lake, Jamie Heim, and one from the, as a Southern Township representative, Mr. Paul Buckington. I assume that's how you say that. I would move it. Does somebody want a second?
I'll second.
Seconded by Commissioner Jukovic, and I'd look to Deputy Administrator Fritzinger. I agree that's a mouthful to frame it.
Mr. Chair, Commissioners, I think Commissioner Jewell has framed this to the greatest extent. You did receive several weeks back a memo with the actual applications from these three individuals. I've not received any responses of concern related to the three individuals who have requested appointment. And with that, the board would be asked to consider the appointment of their terms, which would expire April 30th of 2023.
Any discussion? Clerk Chapman, can you call the roll?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Jukovic?
Aye.
That's all I have, Chair Jukovic. Back to you.
Thank you very much. We are now, it's the end of our regular agenda. We're at Commissioner Discussion Items and Reports. Commissioner Nelson, and then anyone at home.
Thank you, Chair Commissioner. One, I just want to congratulate the people of St. Louis County. Once again, I could not be more proud as an elected official in this county. 84.67%, Clerk Chapman, voted in this last election. 84.67% of our population. Literally one of the highest in the nation. In my township, Fayal Township, again, over 90% of the people voted. And it's just, it renews my faith in the system to see that many people and to see St. Louis County, again, leading the way. So no matter if you're happy with the outcome in all of these different races or not, you got to be happy with the fact that we had voter participation that truly leads the way, not only in the state of Minnesota, but in the nation. So, and with only one recount left, I believe, in St. Louis County, I got to tell you, our results have held up wherever they've been questioned or scrutinized. And some of these races and some of these small communities, I had three city councilors in the city of Mountain Iron that were within 10 votes that we just completed yesterday. So, but again, the participation, just phenomenal. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Anyone else? Okay, I need a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Moved by McDonald, second by
Jewell.
Jewell. Thank you, Frank. And roll call, please.
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson? Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Jukovic?
Aye. Thank you very much. Everyone have a good Thanksgiving. Eat lots of turkey. This meeting's adjourned.